not a chapter that will make things difficult for you as you go stage by stage. It's a very simple chapter. It's a very simple topic. And the basics I have put on the board, you can see I have written it in different colors. I have written it in different colors, the reason being so that you do not get confused with one part from the other. So I have segregated it that way. Coming to decimals, now what are these decimals? Decimals are numbers that come after a whole number. There is a time that we can write certain numbers as whole numbers or go to the next number. The numbers that fall between two consecutive numbers form decimal numbers. For example, if I am going from 2 to 3, the very next number after 2 is 3. But for us to reach from 2 till 3, there are decimal numbers or fractions in between. So from 2, I go to 2, 1 upon 4. That means 1 fourth. Then I go to 2, 1 upon 2. That is 2 and a half. Then I go to 2, 3 upon 4. That is 2 and 3 fourths. And then I reach 3. Similarly, if you look at your scale, if you take your scale, you will find centimeters marked on it. So you have 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 6 centimeter, 7 centimeter, 8 centimeter, 9 centimeter, and 10 centimeter. But in between that we go from 1 centimeter to the next centimeter, here I have a scale. So you can see all centimeters. Now, when I go from 0 to 1, there are 10 lines in between. Similarly, when I go from 1 to 2, there are 10 lines in between. That means each centimeter has been divided into 10 equal parts. And each part is called a millimeter. So when I am going from 1 to 2 and I go only halfway, I call it 1.5. Because the first line after 1 will be 1.1, then 1.2, then 1.3, then 1.4, then 1.5, and so on till you reach 2. So, here each centimeter has been divided into 10 equal parts. Similarly, when I am going from one number to another number, I need to know the number of equal parts that it is being divided into before I reach the next number. And in mathematics also, we have 10 divisions before we reach the next number. That is, we have 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and then it goes to the next number, or the whole number increases by 1. That way it goes on. There is no fixed segregation of lines that are, or numbers that are between one number to the other. It may be, there may be hundreds of divisions, it may be thousands of divisions, it may be 10 divisions. But this division part that comes after the whole number is called a decimal. Now here, the first one, decimal fraction. Fractions having denominators as 10, 100, 1000, etc. are called decimal fractions. A fraction that has its denominator as 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores, all in powers of 10, not multiples of 10. Multiples of 10 is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. I am talking about powers of 10. That means 10 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 10. That's 10. So when I have a fraction with 10 as a denominator, 100 as a denominator, or 1000 as a denominator, they are all decimal fractions. Or they form decimal numbers. We come to the next one, which is called decimal number formation. How can a decimal number be formed? A decimal number gets formed when you have a simple fraction and a proper fraction having denominators as 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores, whatever. Or else, if it is an improper fraction and it cannot be divided completely by the denominator, leaving no remainder, it forms a decimal number. So I have put an example out here. An improper or mixed fraction can be changed to a decimal number. How? So I take 7 upon 2. I divide 7 by 3. 2 goes into 7 3 times, leaving a remainder of 1. Now usually I cannot carry on my division. In order to carry on my division any further, I need to put a point on it, a decimal point. This decimal point gives me the freedom to put a 0 along with the remainder 1 to make it 10. The moment I put a point here, I put a 0 in the remainder. And now 2 goes into 10 5 times and I will get a perfect decimal number 3.5. What does 3.5 mean? 3 and a half. If you look at this 7 upon 2, and if I change this to a mixed fraction, let's do that. So 2 goes into 7 3 times, remainder 1. What do I get? 3, 1 upon 2, that is 3 and a half. 3 and a half is the same as 3.5. So decimal numbers are formed either when the number is about 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. And if it is not upon 100, and if it is an improper fraction, or even a proper fraction, my idea is to make the denominator 100. If I cannot make the denominator 100, whether it's proper or improper, I need to divide it. And in the process of division comes the decimal point. Because when it does not divide any further, I put a point and add a 0 to the remainder and carry my division on and on and on. Till I reach where it cannot divide anymore, or it's repeatedly dividing itself. And that is where rounding off comes, we talk about that later. But this is how a decimal number formation takes place. Let's come to the decimal notation. What notation do I follow when I'm using a decimal number? What is notation? Notation is numeration. Now we know our numeration. Our numerations are units, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores. What happens when it is a decimal number? Now a decimal number has two parts. I've written here 23.75. This 23 represents the whole part. That means it is a perfect number. It is a perfect number. It's number 23 that we know in mathematics. Because 2 has been multiplied by 10 and 3 has been multiplied by 1 to get me 23. 20 plus 3, 23. So this is the whole part. The part that comes after the decimal point is called the decimal part. How do I break it up in the notation? Come here and see here. 23 point, now point 75. Do I say 75? No, it's wrong. Never say 75. When you put the point, the moment you put point, after that every number is to be called as a single digit. So it will be 23.75, not 75. Now let's see the notation. 23, so 20 plus 3. 7 is upon 10, 5 is upon 100. That is the rule. After the decimal point, the first decimal place is always upon 10. The second decimal place is upon 100. And the third decimal place is upon 1000. We are only dealing with upon 10, upon 100, upon 1000. You do not get any further than 1000. So you have to know your decimal places till upon 1000. So this 7 is in the first decimal place. This 5 is in the second decimal place. And you have a third number which will be in the third decimal place. In this example, it's not. Let's see anywhere have I put here with 3 decimal places. Here. See here. 2.890. 8 is in the first decimal place. 9 is in the second decimal place. And 0 is in the third decimal place. So to the max, you will be asked, or you have to learn only the 3 decimal places. And you also have to learn that the first number, the first digit that comes after the decimal point, that first number is the first decimal place and therefore it goes upon 10. The second digit goes upon 100. So the digit in the first decimal place is upon 10. The digit in the second decimal place is upon 100. And the digit in the third decimal place is upon 1000. How do I write the words? 23.75. I have circled point because you have to write point. When you are writing in number names or writing in words, you have to write POINT. You can't put a dot and say I have written point. You can't write 23.75. No. 23 POINT. Point 75. We now come to like and unlike decimals. How do I differentiate when decimal numbers are like and when decimal numbers are unlike? Now here I have written number. This LO is not known, it is number. Number of decimal places decides if like or unlike. Same number of decimal places, like. Different number of decimal places, unlike. So, if you have two numbers, comparing two numbers, and both of them have the same number of decimal places, then they are like decimals. Then they are like decimals. It doesn't have to be that both are 20, or both are 30, or both are 40. It's got nothing to do with the whole number. Confirming whether two fractions are like or unlike is not got anything to do with the whole number or with the whole part. We always look at the decimal part and we count the decimal places. If two numbers or two decimal numbers have the same number of decimal places, they are called like. If they do not have the same number of decimal places, then they are called unlike. For example, see here, 0.1, 0.2. One decimal place, one decimal place. Both are like decimals. Come to the next one. 2.31, 4.7. Here it is 1, 2. There are two decimal places. But here it is only one decimal place. So it becomes unlike. Now here I will just give you one example here in the center. So that you understand it. Let's take an example like 2.009 and 10,408.023. Watch this carefully. Both these decimal numbers are like decimals. This is 10,000, nothing but to do with being like or unlike. This is only 2, got nothing to do with like or unlike. It is the number of decimal places. It is not got to do anything with the whole number. This number is only 2 and this number is 10,408, such a big number. But both of them only have 3 decimal places. 1, 2, 3. So both of them will be called like decimals. So decimal, like decimals and unlike decimals is not got anything to do with the whole part. It is got to do with the decimal part. Now we come to equivalent decimals. Equivalent decimals are decimals that are equal in length. The value is the same. That means the whole part is the same, the decimal part is also the same. When the whole part is the same and the decimal part is also the same, then they are called equivalent decimals. But now you say, sir, here we have 3 decimal places, 1, 2, 3. And here you have only 2 decimal places, 1, 2. What happens here? The 2 and the 2 is the same. The 8 and the 8 is the same. The 9 and the 9 is the same. Here is 0. You can put a 0 here. And the moment you put a 0 here, they both will have the same number of decimal places. And they will become like decimals. So 2.89 is the same as 2.89. Similarly, I'll give you one more example. If I write 2.50 is the same as 2.5. Because I can put a 0 there and both will look the same. So when the whole part and the decimal part are equal in value, they are called equivalent decimals. Comparison of decimals. But actually the comparison of decimals is made first comparing the whole part. And if the whole part is the same, then you compare the decimal part. We first compare the whole part, if same, then we compare the decimal part. The number before the decimal point is called the whole part. The number or the digits after the decimal point are called the decimal part. Now look at the example. I have 96.12 and I have 96.13. 9 and 9 is equal, I have drawn a line. 6 and 6 are equal, I have drawn a line. That means 96 and 96 is the same. Here is 0.1. Don't call this 12 and 13 children. It is not 0.12 and 0.13. After the point, you have to call out each digit individually by its name. So this is not 0.12 and 0.13. You don't differentiate that this is 12 and that is 13, so 13 is bigger. This is not 13, this is 0.13. And this is not 12, this is 0.12. So 96, yes, you can say. So 96 is the same. 0.1 is the same. But here is 0.12. The next one is 0.12 and here it is 0.13. So because 2 is smaller and 3 is greater, therefore 96.13 is greater than 96.12. So this is all the explanation that you need to know about decimals. As we progress in the exercise, you will understand better and know how the sums are solved and how these concepts fit in the exercise that we will be doing in the next video. All this has to be copied in your notebook. Please do not forget to do that. The chapter will begin with all this explanation and these definitions and this example written